News Channel 5 at 6 is back now with beetles. They're small but deadly to trees right here in our region.
And they're strong enough to wipe out ash and sugar maple trees altogether. News Channel 5's David Schneider tells us what you can do to help in tonight's Champlain Connection.
And I'm not seeing any exit holes here.
He's not looking for exit holes from a bullet, but from something just as deadly to trees anyway.
When you get a forest decline, like we're liable to see in the case of emerald ash borer, it's the kind of thing that kind of gets my attention. You
know. Mark Malkoff is volunteering to check the trees around his house for two invasive species of beetle with the potential to wipe out ash, maple, and other hardwood trees across the whole region. The director of the Adirondack Park Invasive Plant Program, or APIP, says the threat from the emerald ash borer and the Asian longhorn beetle is real.
So we're really concerned about continued tree mortality in upwards of millions of trees.
The impacts are going to be very noticeable even to people that can't identify species of trees.
The Asian longhorn beetle goes after many species of hardwood but has a particular taste for sugar maple. It lays its eggs in the trunk where the larvae hatch and mature.
It will create these tunnels. So here's a cross-section on the left here that shows those tunnels.
And once it's fully grown,
it comes out this hole, and it's a very large exit hole. It's large enough that you can actually stick a pencil into it.
Those tunnels damage the tree's ability to circulate nutrients, and it eventually dies. The emerald ash borer is just as deadly, but it goes after ash trees. The exit holes are smaller, but you can see signs of where the insect was crawling around under the bark.
It has these S-shaped larval galleries.
Smith says the best line of defense against the little tree killers is prevention and close monitoring. The U.S. Department of Agriculture is asking anyone to keep an eye on sugar maples and ash trees around their property, like Malkoff is doing. The USDA has a website set up to help.
And this is their website, beetledetectives.com, and it's a really user-friendly website.
It's got information on the beetles and what to look for, as well as a place to log your findings.
And then you just click on this tab.
Property owners will likely be the first to spot the beetles in the region. The USDA is counting on them to use the website to alert them as soon as the insects arrive. And another thing to remember.
The main pathway for these forest pests to spread once they're introduced into the U.S. is by firewood. So moving infected firewood from one location to another.
So scientists say don't bring in firewood from outside the region and join people like Mark Malkoff in keeping watch.
It's sobering and it's something we need to pay attention to.
With Champlain Connection, David Schneider, News Channel 5.